I've recently tried to make an effort to catch up on the animated features I have not seen yet. One of those was Alpha and Omega, which I did not see on its theatrical release due to lack of interest. Well, now I've seen it, and whew, I think this is one of the worst animated films I've seen. It's basically an entire film of all the unfortunate, untrue stereotypes people think every computer animated film has. And I'll explain why this does not even elicit a smile from me. My biggest problem with Alpha and Omega is the two main characters. Humphrey and Kate, two wolves who end up far away from home, have zero personality. They are just there to quibble at one another on occasion and then ultimately fall in love with no character development whatsoever. There's not much emotion and chemistry between the two, and they just fall for each other because the plot demands it. There's also this strange Romeo and Juliet type subplot running through where, because one is an alpha and the other is omega, they cannot become romantically involved. However, it's weakly explained and has little bearing on the plot. After all, they're both wolves and are clearly the same species, so it's a strange way to create conflict and drama. Kate's sister is even an omega, despite her parents and sibling being alphas. How does that work? Is there a selection process? The main storyline doesn't seem to have many stakes involved. When Kate and Humphrey are taken and shipped away, they land in another forest. While they do encounter bears, tourists, and golf-playing birds, it doesn't seem like that different of a location. Compare this to other animated films where characters end up outside their natural habitat. In Rio, Blue finds himself in a world he hasn't inhabited since birth, and because he's been domesticated in snowy Minnesota, he's a complete fish out of water upon finding himself in Rio and the Brazilian jungle, and his lack of flying skills complicates things further. In all the Toy Story films, the toys find themselves in a new and larger environment than they're used to, whether it be a toy destroyer's house, the big city, or a dictator-run daycare. And even in Open Season, which I'm not much of a fan of, it makes sense why its main character is completely lost and out of sorts when he's transferred from his familiar home to the forest. But in Alpha and Omega, they're just in a different forest. Outside of being away from their family, what's the major dilemma here? That I don't care about either of these two doesn't help matters, and in the end, I'm not invested in whether they return home or not. Incidentally, while them being transported to another forest has to do with repopulating the species, unlike Rio, this doesn't drive the plot whatsoever, and just feels like an easy way to get them elsewhere. What's wrong with poachers? At least then you would have had an antagonist that would prove a serious problem. Then there are the supporting characters, who are just as poorly defined. The film's antagonist, voiced by Dennis Hopper, wants to go to war against the Omegas because he's evil, I guess. I mean, there's a territory thing, but it's not explored very well, and the film has trouble dividing them between the two plots. Then there's Kate's mother, whose whole shtick is saying very disturbing ways to mess with her enemies, but it comes across as inappropriate rather than funny. Humphrey's buddies are basically your stereotypical second bananas with the goofy one and the fat one. There's yet another additional subplot where Kate's potential suitor and her sister start to slowly fall for each other, but they're just as dull and personality-deprived as the leads. Kate and Humphrey are also aided on their journey by a couple of golf-playing birds who contribute nothing of substance to the plot and were not the least bit funny, with the writers giving them mainly stupid and unoriginal jokes. Really, the focus of the film should have been the journey home, and that's it. All these other characters and situations just feel superfluous and padding. Then there are some really weird scenes that appear throughout the movie. When we see the mating and howling scenes, they're incredibly awkward, with the wolves dancing to really bad music and moving in ways that probably earned the film its PG rating. And the jokes are incredibly embarrassing. A lot of it are tired crew jokes, and even throw in a couple sex jokes in there that don't work at all. The whole script has not one funny joke in its entire running time. Even worse is the least suspenseful ending ever. There's a whole silly thing where Humphrey feels rejected and leaves the forest, and we know beat by beat what's going to happen. We don't even have time to feel sympathetic for him because it's obvious the film is nearing the end and the two are going to get together. Not to mention the ending, where the audience is meant to think Kate is dead, and I'm thinking, just hurry up and get to the end credits, because I don't care at all what's going on. And in the most ridiculous example of the dead character is not really dead or is brought back to life trope, she is recovered by Howes. And everything is cheery and okay and roll credits. I guess before I finish off, I should discuss the animation, which is some of the weakest CG animation I've seen in a theatrically released animated feature. The character designs are already boring to begin with, and I really have to question the haircuts on the female wolves. But the character animation is awkward, the motion blur is distracting, and the backgrounds are pretty basic and cheap. The whole film is just ugly to look at. Maybe if it was direct video, I'd give it a little leeway, but people pay $10 plus 3D surcharge to watch this in the cinema, and frankly, they deserve better. In conclusion, I got no joy out of watching Alpha and Omega. And they had talented people working on it, like any animated project does, so it just sad to see this film with just a dull story with no personality anywhere on the screen. In fact, I'll give this movie a better plot. Kate and Humphrey are kidnapped by poachers, and instead of ending up in another forest, they get trapped in the zoo. And the whole film is basically The Great Escape, but set in the zoo. And in the process, they actually learn things about each other, and then once they do escape, then they return home. No Alpha and Omega subplot, no territory war. Just a simple love story. Is it cliche? Sure. But I think it had much better potential for a sweet story than what they tried to cram into this film, which did absolutely nothing for me. See you next time.